Coffee Beautiful Souls. Welcome to you guys pick a card. For this reading, we are going to take a look at love. What's next in love? Now, if you are already with your partner, you can look at this also, because then you can see what's next in your guys' relationship. What's the next step for you guys? I'm being rude once again. Let me introduce myself. My name is Missy from the Phoenix Star Tarot. If you are new here, hi, welcome. I'm thankful that you have found me. If you like the vibration, then don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell so that you get notified every time your girl posts a video. And if you are already part of the fam, the tribe, then you know how we do. Love. Thankful that you're back again. So this is pile number one, 2 and 3. I will give you guys 30 seconds to breathe in, breathe out, and choose your pile. You will hear 3 high pitch notes, so it will oomph you up, okay? So that you know. breathe in, breathe out, and choose your pile. I will see you at your pile. Pile one, let's take a look for you guys when it comes to this and to the next love. What's next in love? Let's see the main card. We will have 3 questions. So let's start with the first question. That is, what's next in love? Let's see what's next in love for you guys. Pile one. This one felt like this, so what's next for you in love is relax, is something where you will sit, contemplate, you know. It's very, very stable, knowing what you want when it comes to love, like very relaxed. But this person is making you think a lot, you know, before you make a decision or before you do something, you know. You have to think about it. Or he, she, they, it is somebody that thinks a lot, but is really in their head or mind. But this is going to be a situation where you will think a lot of whatever step you will take, you know, in that kind of a way. I do see for some of you, this person, this is about your family situation, like you have children with this person, or you are somebody with a child, or they are somebody with a child. So let's see the lesson for you when it comes to this situation or love. What's the lesson for part one? Oh, 5 in reverse. If you thought that this is gonna be a challenge, no honey, it's not gonna be a challenge. As I said, this is somebody very calm, collected, you know. It's thinking of, strategizing of their next step, but this is not a competition. Why do I hear Jesse? Like, this is not a competition, honey. Like, really, or this is a competition, but she said this is a competition. For you, it's not a competition. You know, it's very calm. It's really, this person has already strategized and planned. So, for you guys, the lesson in this relationship is really, you don't have to come on so strong. Perhaps in the past you had a relationship that you had to battle to let people know that this is your place, this is your person. But no, you don't have to do this with this one. This one be like, no, there ain't no competition. You are it. There are no other ones, kind of a way. This person is like, no, I have thought before I get to you, you know. Let's see. What's the result of this love? The cards are flying lovely. I will take this like so. But the result of this love, I must say, this person might be not so adventurous. You know? Not be looking at the ones being in reverse. Like this person know what he, she, they, it wants, but it's not the result. I will say like, it's really like, it will, it can bore you. If you are somebody that is more in the fire energy, and this is somebody that is really in a hold up, like not yet, just wait. It's like really like strategize and plan, as I said, with the Four of Swords. Strategize and plan before we take action. And you are more on a person like, let's do, let's begin. Like your Mars is heightened, your fire, or you have a fire energy, you have lots of fire in your chart, or it speaks more in your chart. Then this person can, in a moment, it can, they can board you. Not boring as if boring, but you know, there is always that somebody that wants to like really in detail strategize and plan stuff, you know, or want to do nothing spontaneously. Let's think about it, as I said in the beginning, let's think about it, you know, they will let you think, but sometimes you just want to do. And I really see you guys that if they keep this up, then the result of this is that if this is you or this is them, that does that, your fire, your pitta is low, then somebody's gonna choose for them own. Somebody be like, you know what, I'ma go out and search some excitement outside of this relationship, you know, in that kind of a way, because there is no excitement. I know we all want something that isn't, you don't have, that isn't, you don't have to compete, but it doesn't have to be boring, you know. Like I'm getting, if you know you are going with a yogi or somebody that meditate the whole time and is very kumbaya, then you know that if you have fire in you, that somebody sometime it'd be like, are we really going to meditate once again today the whole day? Aren't we going to do something? You will get bored and you will want to have that fire that is in you wants to also, you know, you are going to make wrong decision. That is why I always say that everybody in their chart, they have something more of than the other. And that is how the conflict is. If you look around you also, I love to observe people, especially if they are in a relationship. You can see who is the homebody and who is the fire, more action, who is the late sleeper and who is the early sleeper, who is the thinker of the group, or the, you know, in that kind of a way. So yeah, let's take a look at your advice card. What advice do you guys, your spiritual team, has for you when it comes to this relationship? New life, it's different. Oh, if it's like that, yeah. Like, it's different. It's going to get you to learn situation in another way, okay? It's going to teach you how to love in a different way. And for some of you, if you are the homebody, somebody that is like, you know, not really taking action, or, you know, it's going to teach you the different. It, one person is different than the other, but you can balance those two together. If you have, if you know the balance, you will find this okay. You know, if you be like, you know what, I'm gonna try this, it's gonna be okay. This is a new thing, as this card, new life, is saying. This person, I really see when it comes to love, or next in love, you can be in a relationship and watch this also. That is why I say next in love, because this can be that your relationship in the beginning was very wild and travel here, travel there, and then suddenly there is like, especially in the time that we are in right now, things have slowed down. You guys have found your peace and there ain't no, you know, lots of issue. For example, if your person was really going out or you were going out, now you see that how the wheels are turning. Especially, there is always a time in somebody's life that they change. And this is for you guys. If you are in a relationship and your relationship was party hardy go, you will see how the wheels are turning and things are going to slow down. You are enjoying the self and enjoying your partner. More of a homebody. Like going in your neighborhood kind of a thing instead of long distance travel and stuff. But this is a different way of life for you guys. So that is it for you guys, my lovely, beautiful pile 1. Let's take a look at pile 2. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, okay? Bye-bye. So, pile number 2, let's take a look at you guys. Let's see, what's next in love for you guys? Let's see the question. What's next in love? One card, please. Thank you. So, for you guys, you have the 5 of Swords. Oh, we were chilling at the 1. So, for the 5 of Swords, when it comes to love, change, but not for the better. It's like somebody is choosing for themselves. Somebody is very greedy when it comes to love right now. Like, really greedy. Like hurting other people just to have more. Like it was all fun and games, but now not anymore. Now it's really like you are being obsessive or greedy about stuff. You know, sometimes when we were little, you were doing a game with a group of people, but there was always that one that took it too far, and then one child must cry. You know, this is it. You in that kind of way, there is a situation when it comes to this relationship or what's next, that somebody is like, I keep hearing the word na 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 na, you know, very, it's not fun. You are overdoing it. It's not fun anymore. Like first, yes, it was fun and game, but not anymore. So let's see the lesson for you when it comes to this situation or love. Let's see for you guys, what's the lesson? What's the lesson? Thank you. Oh, 5 of Swords. 7. This is my cheating, conniving, thief card, y'all. 7 of Swords. Choose it for yourself. That's the lesson. You need to realize, like, okay, wait a minute. Look at how they are looking at each other also. You need to realize, like, wait a minute. I'm giving my cup of love to somebody that, you know. And the funny thing is, here he has gained 5 swords of these two people. Like, 5, like, this person is collecting life or love kind of a situation. But then you realize, as for you, the lesson is like, you know what kind of a person this person is. You know what kind of a greediness, or how he, you know, there is always that one person that been around town, everybody knows him or her, you know, that share his cup of love to everybody and their mama. And you realize, like, no, wait a minute, before you steal my cup, before you making my cup dirty with your negative energy, I'ma grab my 5 swords and leave you with 2, honey. And you are like, this is the lesson, choosing for yourself. Choosing for yourself if you want this love, yes or no. If you are going to accept this mischievous, greedy way that this person comes towards you, or whatever this situation is. Let's see for you guys the result of this situation. The result of this situation or a love. Let's see. So yeah, let's see the result of this love or situation. You have the 10 of Wands in reverse. Like this, this the result of it is that you are not going to take this stuff with you. No, no. You'll be like, you know what? This ain't working. This isn't what I was signed to. You have got the assignment wrong. like, no, I'm grown, or I'm wise, or this isn't it. So you be like, no, I'm not even going to bother to take all your baggage with me. No, I'm gonna drop all of this. This situation, you need to do some karmic kind of a thing, shadow work, because it ain't working. So really, this love is teaching you how to come up for yourself, how to choose the self, because this person is really collecting trophies, if I may say. It's collecting trophies. Like, no. And it's up to you if you are going to, like, be the back lady or the back man, you know, Erica Badu, back lady kind of a thing. So let's see for your advice cards. I love these cards. They be like, no, I'm gonna, you know, we are going to give you the answers quick. Yin is the receiving, is the feminine energy. Like being in the receiving mode, you know? For some of you, perhaps you are the one that's like this person. It's like action and collecting, you know, trophies and stuff. But I really see this energy, the yin energy, if this ain't you, I really see it for you guys. Like, even if you are a male, the balance of the masculine and the feminine energy is the way of life, you know? Because then you know how to take action, but also how to receive. How to be feminine and also know, not feminine, but how to be in the feminine energy of beauty, love, and really that... I'm a Venus ruled, so I really like food, care, the senses, the smell, the touch, the love, the eyes, in that kind of a way. That you are appreciative of this of yourself to begin with, so that you realize what you deserve and what not. You know, instead of taking this. Like mischievous things, you know, for some of you the lesson is also for some of you like, don't search for the answer outside of your relationship, you know, because sometimes you can work. Because if this is you, that means that you are the one that's collecting, you know, the trophies, you know, being mischievous and hurting your partner with the choices that you make by only being, like, choosing for yourself and take action and do. So being more in the yin, like being more in the receiving mode, because this can also be a defense mechanism, like, oh, I'm scared to get hurt. So I'm a fast and quick say deuces, you know, or fast and quick like drop the ball, because I don't have time for this kind of love. Now there is a way of saying fast and quick dropping the ball, and there is a way of just knowing your boundaries, what you will take, not will take. Like if this is out being scared, then that is fast and quick. But if this is like, no, I just don't tolerate people that do mischievous things, then this is your boundaries, you know. So the yin card is saying, like, be more in the receiving mode, you know. Or if you are looking every time to people that has more of the masculine energy, or you have more of the masculine energy, you need to search for somebody that brings more balance to your yang energy. That is also the thing that I was talking about with the pile number one, that, you know, if you look at a relationship, you will see the one is more of action taking and the one is more of like going with the flow. So for you guys, if you have more of that masculine, balancing it with the feminine energy. So the advice card for you guys is being more in the receiving mode. So there it is for you guys, my lovely, beautiful pile too. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you on another reading of mine. Bye bye. So, pile number two, let's take a look at you guys. When it comes to love, what is next for you guys? When it comes to a love, let's see. So, for you guys, what's next in love? One piece. Thank you. Oh, your wish is going to come true, honey. Your wish is going to come true when it comes to love. There is something that is going to be of celebrating. If you have manifesting a type of person in your life, you want a specific type of person, seeing 2112 on the camera, like 2112. You know, I don't know what it means, but you can Google it. Really, I really see you guys like knowing what you want. Knowing what you want. You have really like manifesting this, and you are going to have victory. This is going to be good, this love, because even if it's not good, it is the thing that you want, so you are going to get it, but you are going to learn the lesson of it. Talking about the lesson, let's take a look at what the lesson is for you when it comes to the situation or love. And keep in mind, this can also be you in a relationship. So perhaps you have a wish for you and your partner, and your wish is now going to come true, my love. So let's take a look at the lesson for you when it comes to this situation or love. Now this is like this, so I'm gonna take it more like so, okay? So this is great partnering. This is a great partnering. For some of you, this can be you being committed, like this person telling you like let's combine things, like balancing things, like live together things, marriage things, you know, like let's become one, I will drink from your cup and you will drink from my cup, kind of a thing, like what's mine is yours and what's yours is mine, so in that kind of a way. But I really see that for you guys, this is you are going to learn the lesson of having balance in a relationship, having balance in love, you know. You are going to learn how to have patience with another person and what that person is going to teach you. And that person also is going to learn how to have patience with you. As I said, you drink from my cup, I drink from your cup. But, you know, if somebody is like, look, 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 your cup, and you be like, sip, 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 sip their cup, you be like, honey, this isn't in balance. Like, let's have this balance, you know. You can don't give too much, like keep things in balance is what I'm trying to say. So this love is the love that you will see how things is in balance. As I saw the mirror number of 2-1 and 1-2, so it's a mirroring of you. So let's take a look at the result of this love or situation. What is the result of it? You know, later on the line, what's the result of this love? Oh, that's two. We have the tower. The tower was the one that flipped first, yeah. We have the tower, so something's going to happen fast suddenly. But let's turn this one, let's see what's happening suddenly. The King of Swords, yeah. The King of Swords. Now, I do see for you guys, whatever that is happening suddenly, looking at things in a bigger perspective, things are going to change pretty fast, pretty quick. Like, you both are the same, but not the same. Like, for example, this person is the head of the relationship, or you are the head of the relationship, somebody the strict one in the relationship. When you have a new start, a new beginning, you know, the result of it, it's going to learn you, this relationship, it's suddenly going to change you in being somebody that is looking at the bigger perspective in things, is strategizing, is using your mind, you know. This is something of I'm seeing a very sexy person though. I have a weak thing for people that looks like a male. I'm in the male figures, you know. I like me a masculine. So, like it's looking very boss, you know, boss situation and looking sexy in a suit. I'm getting that kind of a vibe, like really. but yet has love. So I really see that this result of this love is a thing that it will teach you how to like strategize what you want in love, how you see it. You know, this is a new start, a new foundation, being very strategic. Perhaps you guys are going to buy a house together. You have a mentality of like focus, what we're gonna do, like let's think about it kind of a way, like where do we see ourselves. You are not looking at today, tomorrow. No, you are looking at the bigger picture. Where is this love going? What are we are going to do? What are your dreams, your wishes, your plan, in that kind of a way? So this is the love is still there. And the reason I said it is because look at this. You have the King of Cups underneath the deck. So you have the King of Swords and the King of Cups. So the love is still there. Let me put that King of Cups with. And then we have the World. So definitely a new beginning for you guys. So even though you guys are very strategic and planning and what to do, you guys have the love for this foundation on or whatever that it is that you guys want to do. So let's see, for your advice card that you guys, your spiritual team wants to give you when it comes to this love, the advice cards. So for you guys, all that glitters ain't gold. that is what I'm getting for you guys is like, when it comes to this love, if you don't be, that is why I saw that businessman looking very, but don't be, keep in mind, you might have same vision, same dreams, looking at the King of Swords, but it's not the, like, if this is love, it's not an investment of business, it's love. So don't forget to balance the love, because of course a marriage is an investment, but if you guys have more of, oh, let's be a partner in business but also in love, then you are having more of the material world, the material things, and you forget about the balance of love in it. So yes, you may have those goals, but you need to, don't forget, this all started with love. Unless this is your wish to having a love life with somebody that you can also do business with. But keep in mind, the material world is not the answer when it comes to love. Because then you guys have greed, more of a greed for the gains with this partnership instead of the love of this partnership. So this is a kind of a fool's gold, like going, portraying to be something else or being the perfect partner because we have a business together, we have this together, but once the door closes and nobody's looking at you, it's like we are actually brothers or sisters. We are not even talking together in that kind of a way. So look out that you guys are not wearing a mask when it comes to love. And I'm not going to not to bash the social media kind of a love, but you do have, and I see some of them and I'm like, honey, I can see through that whole shebang that it's fake. Okay, like yes, it's nice and lovely on camera, but your energy is saying different. You know, that it's like on camera when we say, okay, let's do this movie, it's more for the outer world, for the because we have together a business, a social media kind of a thing, because the star is also the Aquarius sign, and the Aquarius sign is ruled by is ruling also the internet, Uranus ruling the internet and stuff. So the new new world stuff, so internet and that kind of a thing. So it's like, oh, we are doing it for the gram, oh, we are doing it for the TikTok. But once we put that aside, that's it. That's your relationship, like for the gram. So really watch out, one, that you don't, this love that it is, like for example, you perhaps are wishing for, you seeing people on social media having that love, and you be like, oh, I wish I had that kind of a love. Honey, you don't know what's happened behind closed doors. You don't know what kind of a puppet game they are playing, like putting on masks just for the show. You know, you don't know that. So really, I always say, if you wanna manifest a kind of love, don't look at other people's home, because you don't know what's the cross of that home. You don't know what's happened behind closed door. Perhaps that person is very manipulating. You know, as I said, this needs to be in balance. You need to have patience and keep things nicely in balance when it comes to this love. But if you guys are not keeping this in balance, and it's more of a King of Swords type of situation, this new beginning, what this result will be when it comes to this love, you're gonna lose, honey. It's all a portrayal of for the gram or for the outer world. But you are very craving this. So keep things in balance, as I said, with this card, okay? So that is it for you guys, my lovely, beautiful pile 3. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you on another reading of mine, okay? Bye-bye.